Yes! That's what I'm talking about. We have a semi-truck pulling a semi-trailer with our super transformer motorbike inside of it. And my God, is this laggy. Let's go now. Hello, everybody. Mr. Miola here, back playing Scrap Mechanic. God, I'm absolutely loving this game. And it looks like you guys are as well. You guys have been showing so much support on my Scrap Mechanic videos and my creations that I've been creating. And I just want to thank you guys for that. You guys have been incredible. So thank you for all the comments. Thank you for all the suggestions. Thank you for all the thumbs up and all just regularly enjoying my videos. So thank you so much, guys. So last episode, we went and created this transforming motorbike, right? Check it out. Boom. In case you missed it, you can always go and check that video out to see how we made it and how we came to this final product. I think I actually added one thing to it since then, and that was these back thrusters. And these things are absolutely awesome. They kind of just give it like a shit ton of speed. Unfortunately, it kind of makes it really, really hard to control. Like, it makes it super fast. But I figured, what good is it having this compactability, like this able to sort of transform into a compact shape if you got nothing to fit it in? No garage, no nothing. Well. Amongst all of your suggestions, and I mean, there have been like 100 of them, one of the ones that just kept popping up was a semi-truck. You guys want me to build a semi-truck. And you know what? I want to give you a semi-truck. I'm going to try and build a semi-truck for you today. We call them in Australia semi-trailers, but I'm guessing in America they're called semi-trucks. But that doesn't really matter. And I'm thinking what our semi-truck can actually do is maybe have a feature where it can carry around our motorbike here. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I'm not entirely sure if we're going to make that happen, if we're going to be able to make that happen, but we're going to try. So, as for everything, actually, I'm going to leave that over there. As for every build, let's start off by placing down this little fella right here. So I've got a bunch of pictures open of semi-trucks because I didn't really know where to start with this here. And I still don't, but we're going to try our best anyway. Now, when I think semi-truck, I think big, heavy, metal, clunky things. So we're going to be building this build today out of metal, of course. And fingers crossed it goes all right. Fingers crossed it's not too heavy. I don't really know. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. So I'm thinking of actually building this thing. Now, usually you go like symmetrical with builds. This one here, I'm actually thinking of going kind of centering it on a single block, if that makes sense. So let's go something like this for the size wise. Now, this is pretty symmetrical right now. I'm thinking we should, I don't really know. No, we'll go pretty symmetrical. We'll keep it as is. Or should we? You know what? We're going to go one extra block, okay? One extra block wide, all right? Now, every truck has two seats. So finally, we're actually going to be incorporating our passenger seat into this. So I'm guessing driver's seat there. And possibly a passenger seat there. That's not overly symmetrical. Hold on. Let's change that up a bit. There we go. Now you guys are probably thinking, you got the things wrong way around. Well, this is how we have it in Australia. We drive on the right-hand side of the car. In America, you guys drive on the left-hand side of the car. Why is this so much more forward than the other one? Let's go and like put this back a little bit. Like right there. I reckon that's a pretty good width of this, like, vehicle. So, I guess from here, we're going to end up building sort of upwards a little bit, like this. Like I said, I'm kind of going with the flow. We're going to see how it goes. I really have no idea how this is going to look or how it's going to go. We're going to have to work out, like, a vehicle size. So, what I'm actually thinking is because generally, these vehicles sit pretty high, don't they? So I wonder if we can sort of go a bit higher, if that makes a little bit of sense. We're going to have sort of like, I don't really know. All right, let's get rid of that. Let's just stick with the cabin for now. Let's just stick with the part you actually sit in. So can we build? Actually, I'm gonna leave that block empty just in case we want to put some stuff in there. I'm gonna pretty much box this in a little bit. So let's do exactly that. Let's go and box this right up. That's not quite what I had in mind. And generally the cabin sort of knocks off right here. There's not really any like room behind it. That's pretty much all it is. So let's go and block that up right there. Just for now, we'll adjust it. We'll adjust it. We'll give them some doors and some windows and some breathing space. But this is a good start, I think. Now, I'm going to quickly ask a favor of you guys. If you guys are enjoying this series and enjoying the scrap mechanic videos and would like to see more of them, let me know by leaving a thumbs up on this video. Make it rain them thumbs up. And of course, if you guys want to see more, I will be happy to give you more. So, how is this looking for like a window? That's not good at all. That's not even centered. Can I jump up there? I can. I didn't want to break that. Okay. So, that's the center point right here. So, let's go and bring this right up and drag that across and drag that across there. So, that's kind of like our front window right now. How does that look? Can we like see out of it? Can we see out of it? Yep, that's good. I like it. I like it. They also have a window at the back. So, let's go and add that as well. That's might be a little bit too big. Oops, snap. I don't want that there. I don't want that there. Get rid of that. Let's go and put that through there. Is that a good... I like that. That's a good back window. That's a good back window right there. That is fantastic. Very nice. Very nice. Cool. So, I don't even know what this stuff here is even doing there. So, let's get rid of that. That might have actually been like... I don't know what that was doing there, but that was actually kind of cool. Anyways. So, doors. We're obviously going to need doors to get in and out of this thing. So, I guess a door... Nope, be further back. Is that generally where a door would go? Or one more further back? No. I think we had that actually right. So, this is where a door would go. Now, I've got some ideas for doors. I was actually practicing and playing with this, seeing how we could do doors. And I think this is the best way to go. Placing a bearing right there. And then pretty much filling up that spot there. And then we can like... Actually, I don't even know if I like that. I want to scrap that. How's that for a door shape? I think I like that. Then we'll go ahead and get ourselves a controller. Where should we place this? I'm going to place that just there for now, okay? We're going to connect that to that. And that there is going to spin red 90 degrees. So there we go. We've got our door. That works quite nicely, I think. And then we can always go and pop out a little window. Nope, that didn't work. Or maybe I'll take that out as well. Come on. It like clicks there for some reason. I'm not too sure why. But I'm happy to leave like that for now. Okay, so this is what we've got right now. I had a little play around with it and I adjusted it a little bit. So we'll press E on this little switch and the door swings out. We can hop into the seat and I don't really know how you're going to close it from there. But yeah, this is what we got. It's not too bad. It's not amazing, but it gets the job done, I think. And it does both sides. So I'm going to have to set each of the two doors onto separate controllers. That way they don't both open every time we open it like that. And I really like this kind of inverted block here. It kind of just got added to the mix because it had to be, because the door wasn't shutting properly. But I actually quite like it for some reason. It's grown on me. So, we've got the sort of the cabin set now. I think now it's time to throw it back up onto our little mount here and do something with the front of it. So, usually they sit pretty high off the ground, right? So, I'm thinking... I don't know what I'm thinking. So I've been playing around with this for a bit, and I haven't really gotten very far. But I've sort of worked out a system of maybe getting, like, how to get these wheels to turn, right? Unfortunately, we can't, like, put suspension straight on top of a bearing, which is really disappointing. But we've got, like that. Let's go with... this one here now. Sideways. Perfect. Now we want some of these that we used on our hot rod. Maybe one more. Then can we put wheels on? Or is that sort of like two? No, that's actually really good. That's actually okay then. All right. And then like this, right? So this is what I got in mind right now. Why can't that connect? That there? Like that? What was the difference between that and the other side? Should this all be one block? This should all be one block further forward. Oh, we should really chuck some wheels on the back if we're going to test this out. So let's do that. It's not exactly the same height, but it's more just to see if the thing runs. So where are our motors at? Let's go get one of those. Or two. Probably might need two, actually. There we go. There we go. There we go. Put that the right way. Crank this up a bit. It's going to actually need to be pretty cranked up. Okay. So, does it run? And it turns, but it turns back to front. The turning circle is actually really, really bad. But it turns, nonetheless. The turning circle is horrible. But I guess it's a truck. Trucks aren't really supposed to turn very well, are they? All right, so we're starting to get a little bit of a shape here. Check it out, right? The wheels are looking pretty good. I moved them up a little bit. So the suspension is pretty high, but it does drop quite nicely. We've kind of got this shape going through here. It's kind of like a foot pedal type, foot rest, I guess, type thing. It's now time to maybe work on the rear of the vehicle. So the back of these things usually goes quite long, quite far back, and then there's four wheels on the back end of it. So what we're going to hopefully do is expand this out a fair bit, like out this way. Maybe that long, maybe a little bit shorter. I'm not entirely sure. Let me just, let me have a look. All right. So I guess the back of it, we probably don't need the same sort of bearing system that we had back here. This tray area is going to have to come a little bit out wider though, because it's going to have to match up exactly to where the wheels were on the front part. So the wheels are going to hang roughly around about this part here. Let's go and... Oh, I don't actually mind that. That actually doesn't look too bad. That actually doesn't look too bad at all. Let's go and bring that out. Fill that in as well. Okay, okay. Maybe we'll go... I quite liked that, despite it really having no purpose. Maybe I'll go for that. We'll go for that. We'll go for that. Okay, so that's the back tray sort of thing. Let's go for the same on this side, which was something like that. Very cool. Very cool. Now the wheels are going to sort of hang. How far back should they be? Probably a bit further than that. Probably like that. They're not going to be up here though. They're going to be a little bit lower. So... All right, so check it out. This is what we're kind of looking at right now. It looks weird. I know it does, but have a look. So we've gone for a little bit different. We're kind of not rotating just the wheels. We're going to be rotating these whole... Oh, there's a word for them, and I can't remember it. There's a professional word for these, and I can't remember what it is. I don't really care. So currently, it sits flat. That's how we're looking. It's not... too bad. I think we could do a better job, but it moves, and that's the main thing. Despite the turning circle being absolutely terrible, it's a semi-trailer and it works, so I'm really, really happy with it so far. It's, I don't know, it's probably not high enough. It's probably got to sit like a lot higher when you think about it, but really happy with how we're going. So right now, I think what we should work on is the roof, because right now it's just a flat roof, but on these things, from what the pictures I'm looking at, the roofs tend to go quite high. So it's almost kind of like, they're kind of like a, cabin type thing, like so. Let's go three up and knock that out. And maybe bring this across now. So usually there's sort of something like this. They're actually quite high up like that. So maybe that's all we really need. Maybe that's it. Maybe that actually didn't take that much work after all. Can I jump up to the back there? I can. Yeah. All right. So let's go and bring this down a little bit. Let's bring this down a bit. That out. And we could probably extend. Nope, that's not how I wanted it. That's not it at all. Like this. Yeah, I think I like that. I think that looks pretty cool. How's it look from out here? Oh, it's pretty bulky. It's pretty bulky. All right, so I think that looks pretty cool right now. I actually went and added a whole bunch more wheels at the back just to see if it gives it a little more power. I'm not sure if that's how this game works or not. It might, I don't know, but I think it looks very cool and it gives it that little bit more support that I reckon a truck like this definitely needs. So right now, this is how it's looking. It doesn't look amazing. It looks all right, but it's gonna need a little bit more work still. All right, so this is where we are. I honestly don't know what to think about it. I don't know if it's great or if it's the greatest or it's just plain trash. It's coming along though. We've gone and thrown on like this event. It's kind of like a vent on the front, but it's supposed to be like a grill. It's kind of like a grill type looking thing. And we've also got this like bull bar on the front made from these pipes and some headlights as well, which look really, really cool, I think. I've gone and thrown massive pipes on it, because what do trucks have more than massive pipes? So we've got big pipes on them, and big exhaust pipes at the top, and I don't really know what kind of pipes these ones are at the bottom, but they're just there to look good. And yeah, I've gone and pushed the wheels back a little further. We've got two engines running. Let's go and test this bad boy out and see how it runs. So the front wheels, they're turning pretty well. The back wheels, they operate quite well as well. They kind of drift out a bit at times. And let's see if we can actually flip it, because it doesn't look like we're having much luck flipping it, which is good. We don't want to be able to flip it. So I'm really happy with that. This is where we're at the moment. I guess the next step comes the trailer. The trailer is going to be interesting. I don't really know where to start with that or how to do it, but I'm looking forward to it. All right, guys. So I think I'm pretty happy with the current state of the main part of our semi truck. I've gone and added this blue stuff around the edge. It's kind of like a bit of trimming. I don't know. I think it gives it like a quite nice little touch around all the metal looking stuff. So that's it for that. I think it's time we turn our attention to the trailer part of all of it. Now the trailer part is probably gonna be the bigger part. We're gonna make it out of a different block. I actually don't know what though. Either concrete or wood. Let's build this part out of wood, I think. Now this is gonna be quite big. How wide did we go with this? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 13. Okay, so we went 13 wide. So let's do exactly the same. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I should probably go 5 each side. No, hold on. Wait, what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And then we'll go and make this all long and stuff. Okay, I'm quite happy with that. Now the question is, how wide is our bike? Will our bike fit inside of this? So we got like what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 wide, that is plenty of room. It's actually gonna be quite a tight fit, but I'm happy with that. So now let's go and throw some walls onto the sides of this thing. It's a little bit higher than the last one. A little bit higher again. Okay, let's go bring this back down. Bring this back down like so. There we go. I think that's the size of this. I think the size of this is actually quite nice. How high did I go? 10 high. Let's go and test this against the bike. 1, 2, 3. Actually, we can just drag it straight up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It looks like we're going to be maybe another few. We'll add another like 3 or 4 on top of this, I think, just to be sure. Okay, so this is where we got at the moment. I quite like this height. I think this height is actually really, really good. So now this is where I want to get a little bit tricky with it. So what sort of... Okay, that didn't work. Can we place it? I want to place it roughly here somewhere, right? What sort of height would this have to sit at to sit on top of the truck? Now I want... Okay, that's not good. If we want this to sort of sit upon the truck, I'm thinking of cutting a part out of the back here, if you know what I mean. I'm thinking, right? You're going to want to have the wheels beneath it, right? So let's go and get those. The wheels, where are they even going to sit? They can't really sit on the outside. They're almost going to have to sit on the inside. Or underneath almost. Are you going to have to go for something like that? I think you will. I think that's exactly how you have to do it. But then that's going to stop our bike entering. How wide was our bike? 2, 4. Okay, our bike is 8 wide. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, that's like just gonna fit. Maybe if we're lucky, it's gonna be such a tight fit. It's not the best thing, but it's gonna work, okay? It's gonna work, and that's all that really matters. So let me go on. That's not gonna work. Let me go and place this exactly where we are going to want it, which is sort of around here somewhere. We can probably make this a lot thinner than what it is as well. It's probably a bit longer. It's probably a bit long for what we need it for. But the next thing that I was actually thinking of earlier, which is what I sort of quickly mentioned, was chopping off like a chunk like this, all right? And I didn't really explain myself as to why we were thinking of doing that. But it's basically so that we can try and fit on top of the trailer. So if we go and like fill this in and fill that in, right? And then we go and can we jump on this? We want to kind of like back ourselves underneath. That's actually like perfect almost. We want to kind of sit right about there. Now we got to get out of this thing. This is the downside of this vehicle. Can we hit that switch or what? Please? Please? No? I guess not. So that's sort of what I had in mind. We're going to be carrying around this trailer like that. But we're going to have to get a few things like automated and kind of working weirdly. We'll get there eventually though. The first thing I want to do is get kind of like this back thing working. So we can actually get the bike on top of this, right? And the way we're going to do that, one of the options we have is lifting the back door upwards, right? So it pulls it upwards and then we can drive straight in. But it doesn't really help us get on top of the vehicle. So another sort of option we have is, actually, I'm thinking of this right now. I wonder if this would work. Okay, would that work? Would that work? And we can connect that to a controller somewhere. So let's go and throw... I'm just going to put it on the back for now. Let's put it out here with a switch, okay? So let's say that this here is connected to that. And we want it to go red, okay? So we're going to turn this thing to go red about... Nope, that's too much. Let's try 30 degrees, okay? Oh, we're going to connect it? Of course we do. Of course we do. Okay, 30's a bit much. 30 is a little bit too much. All right. Okay. Let's stop there. How about 15? Does 15 work? It's a little bit better. It's still too much. But hey, if that's the only problem, then I'll take that. So the question is now, so we're trying to get this inside of the semi-trailer. No. Can we get it? Maybe with 4 if we use a bit of rockets? Why? What's catching? What's stopping us? Is it the motor? Yeah, we're slowly getting there. All right. Okay. We've got in. If you can call it that. But we are in, okay? So, can we go and press... Can we, like, go in maybe a little bit further? There we go, there we go, there we go. Stop right there. Can we go and press 1? Yes? Maybe? And then hop out. All right. It is so laggy. So, objects don't like colliding with other objects, I take it. That's fair enough. Press the switch. It raises that back up. And oh my god, the lag. I guess it's like 3 buildings on top of each other and they just don't like that. Let's go and pick this up and place him out there so the game can breathe for a second. There you go. All right, everyone happy now? Fantastic. Well, the other problem we're going to have is when this flips over and packs itself up, it obviously, like, goes way too high for the, well, the limit of this. Like, it goes a lot higher than we can sort of... The roof! It's gonna, like, blow the roof out, basically. So what we're gonna have to do to counter that, apart from... put a back wall on this, is... add sort of like a roof to it, I suppose. Okay, beautiful. So, what should happen now is if I adjust this... Which one do I have to do? Blue. If I adjust this to go blue, maybe 15. It's going to go pretty hard, but... that's going to happen. Okay. All right. That actually works really, really well. That, like, worked almost perfectly. What I have to do while we are testing this, I think, is take it off of the truck and just build a bit of a... like a stilt, almost. So there we go. Okay, that lifts up perfectly. Let's go and get my motorbike. Okay, we're in. Now the question of truth is... don't roll back, don't roll back, don't roll back. Can we fold up? Yes? No? Maybe not. That didn't quite work. It didn't quite work. Oh, God. Now we're, like, trapped in here, aren't we? Okay, so I've made a few adjustments that will hopefully allow us to do this. Let's see if we can get this right. Here we go. Here we go. Yes. Okay, we're in, we're in. Now, can we get this to work? Let's give this a crack. There we go, there we go. All right, now, there we got it. We've got the bike inside of our trailer. We have the bike inside our trailer. That's it. We've got it in there. Well, that's the hard part done. What we are actually forgetting to do is open this backport. How are we going to do this? If we hit the switch... yeah? Maybe? I don't know. Does that work? Or maybe we should actually go 90 degrees blue. Like that. So then what happens is... if we hit the switch... no, that's not the switch. If we hit the switch... that folds out, comes down, and traps it in. I like this. This is good. This is good. Okay, so I made a few adjustments, all right? So... what should happen now is we press E and they fold up. We press E and they open back up. Okay, so now it should work. Okay, let's jump on top of it inside of our little ship thingy, thingy. What I forgot to do, connect this switch to our driver's seat. So now we should be able to go like that and like that. So all we have to do is slowly back up. That wasn't so slowly. And we're not lined up. Okay, so I adjusted it so that it should fit. Let's go and hop out of here because we got one thing left to do. I think we're on. I think we're latched on. What do you mean the switch isn't connected to anything? I think we're attached. We're attached. We've got it. We've got it. We've got the semi-trailer attached. And we can turn.
Yeah, baby.
Look at that. Look at that. Oh, this is two separate vehicles. And they work flawlessly. The only last tester is, can we go ahead now and attach our third vehicle? Where did our bike go? This is gonna get so laggy. Prepare for the lag. Here we go. No, the lag is too much. The lag is too much. Come on. Come on. Yes. Yes. That's it. We're a bit too far in there. Ready? You ready? Go. Come on. Fold up. Fold up. Fold up. Yes. Yes. All right. The motorbike is in. This is so impractical. This is so unpractical. Fold her up, baby. Fold it up. Fold it up. There we go. Okay. Oh my God. This is going to crash. This is going to destroy my computer in any second. Any second, my computer is about to blow up. Come on. Come on. You can do it. Jump. There we go. There we go. Woo! Yes! That's what I'm talking about. So we have a semi-truck pulling a semi-trailer with our super transformer motorbike inside of it. And my God, is this laggy. So there we have it, guys. I think I have absolutely conquered this challenge. We have ourselves our semi-truck that can carry our semi-trailer that can carry our super transformer motorbike. I might come back to this one day. This has been a pretty rough build, and it's probably not as smooth as I could have got it, but I'm pretty happy with how it's gone. So if you like this build, guys, make sure to go ahead and leave a thumbs up on this video. Make it rain them thumbs. But thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to leave more challenges and more suggestions for things that I can build down below in the comments. But that is all for now, guys. Thank you so much. Peace out. Love you all. I will see you in another video tomorrow. Bye for now. Yes. It sort of works. It sort of works. It's gone out of control. I don't know what's happening. Oh, snap. Oh, snap.